Welcome to an exciting half hour of Caribbean Connection with guests Frank Gonzalez, Yvette Cruz, Zeta Luna, and our musical guests Don Omar and Daddy Yankee. All this coming up on Caribbean Connection. Caribbean Connection is sponsored by... And now, your hosts, Jeremy Lindsay and Becky Rosario.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Caribbean Connection. My name is Jeremy Lindsay.
And I'm Becky Rosario. Thank you for joining us for another edition of Caribbean Connection as we look at how Hispanic Americans keep their heritage and culture alive here in the U.S.
And we'll keep you entertained with some great reggaeton music. Here now is our first musical guest. This is Don Omar with Taboo.
Caribbean Connection will return with Yvette Cruz as we look at Hispanic American culture in the U.S. and more music ahead from Daddy Yankee next. For quality video productions for your business, contact Lindsay Entertainment Network. Lindsay Entertainment Network can help you produce quality and effective television commercials for your business, including corporate business video, annual report, training video, or documentary, music video, or concert videos. Call Lindsay Entertainment Network at 413-783-5926 for all your HD quality and effective video production needs. Call Lindsay Entertainment Network.
We'll continue with more music on Caribbean Connection from Daddy Yankee. But first, our next guest shows us how Hispanic culture is promoted through our media here in the U.S.
Vocalizando Tito Nieves, y ese era el aniversario. Si ustedes recordarán, Tito Nieves comenzó, grabó.
I think the Yacos at Ritmo program serves the Hispanic community by bringing different types of music to the community. It makes people feel at home, like they're still within the native country. For instance, they could listen to like bachata, which originated from like Dominican Republic, or cumbia, which originated from Colombia, and different types of music. So it makes them feel at home.
These are the music that we grew up with, and people like, did you just saw that call? The guy was calling me, so he loved the music, and they feel so happy. They say that, wow, you make us remember those times from the late 60s, all the whole 70s and early 80s. I mean, the music is, you know, like, you know, is they have no language.
Besides, they get to listen to current issues that are going on by local leaders. They come in and voice their opinions and tell us about the local issues that are going on in the community. People feel like this is their second home. They feel comfortable calling us and expressing their opinions. They also give us tips about things that are going on in the community.
That's how the people know about it. They come all over from Connecticut because they hear from in this station, you know. and even New York. So we, you know, people call, and Yuma, Amherst, all over. So that's how they most of the time that's how they know through here, you know.
My name is Pedro Delgado. I'm working here for more than 25 years in Eco del Ritmo, sirviendo a la comunidad, serving to the community service. I'm pretty salsa, bachata, and merengue. That's my kind of Latin music in 90.7.
I think the Ecos del Ritmo program benefits Hispanics because we have the opportunity to talk to amount larger people, and it reaches all the way to Hartford, and we're able to let them know about different concerts that are going on, health events, local job fairs for people who are actively looking for employment. It also helps people feel at home, away from home. We have different DJs that cater to different sectors of the community. For instance, Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, people from Spain, people from Central America. And because we have different people who DJ at the radio station that come from different backgrounds, we're able to cover a vast amount of cultures within our program.
Mañana sí. Mañana es viernes todavía, lo puede tener ready.
It's time for more music on Caribbean Connection. Here's Daddy Yankee doing Limbo.
Daddy Yankee, doing the limbo there, how low can you go? Joining us now is Yvette Cruz of the Puerto Rican Cultural Center in Springfield, Mass.
The services that the Puerto Rican Cultural Service provides are vital to our community. They are services that prepare people to become self-sufficient. It is very important that not only we talk about services that we provide, but that the members of our community understand how important it is to contribute to your own community. So people that receive services at the Puerto Rican Cultural Center also understand that they have to share something, that they have to participate and volunteer, and that's how you pay back what you receive at the center. The goal of the annual parade is for us to highlight our culture, make sure that we share our heritage, and that it is a vehicle to unite the community. It is a day of celebration, a day of unity, a day in which everyone is happy, and people that are not of our culture can see who we are. We promote the event through the print media, social media, and also through the radio and TV stations. There's also posters and flyers that we distribute through our different neighborhoods to make sure that people know that the parade is going on. This year was a very special parade. It was a very long parade, very well organized, and we had a team that helped us with that. A group of different backgrounds, different organizations, and that was a highlight for this year because we wanted more people to be included and feel that they own the parade. And also we had in the parade a very special part, and is the Borinqueneers. Those were people who served in the military and weren't recognized, and through a big effort under Gumercindo Gomez here, the gold medal of honor was given to these military individuals that contributed in the war, in different wars. It was really an honor to be able to do that because very few of them are alive today. And, you know, they were invited. Gumercindo was in the front of the parade. And we had a delightful variety, you know, of people. We had the Paso Fino horses. That's part of our culture. You know, 500 years of celebration of that kind of participation opportunity with these horses. There were groups of people that registered to participate, and we had 990 individuals that registered and marched in that parade, which I believe is the highest ever. And I think that it speaks to the opportunity to have people together from diverse backgrounds. I felt that the parade wasn't about only the Puerto Ricans, but something that we were sharing with other people that truly enjoyed it. And it was for us an absolutely delight to have it like that, in which so many people participated, not only in the parade, but in the preparation, the days going into the preparation. It gave the opportunity to people that never worked together to work together, to know each other. And the most important thing in a community is the unity. Together, we can do so much.
Now for more music on Caribbean Connection. Here again is Don Omar featuring Beanie Man with Belly Danza. Oh, no.
This is Beanie Man Zaga. Oh, nani, 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 nani. Jamaican, Puerto Rican connection. Caribbean guys, we have them in a collection. Venezuela, Mexican, and Colombian. All Latino, but they don't feel me sing this song.
Jamaican, Puerto Rican connection. Caribbean guys, we have them in a collection. Venezuela, Mexican, and Colombian.
Coming up, more music from Daddy Yankee and our conversation with Zeta Luna when Caribbean Connection continues next.
Welcome back to Caribbean Connection, and joining us now is Zeta Luna, a board member of the Springfield Puerto Rican Cultural Center. Zeta, welcome.
The Puerto Rican Parade helped the Puerto Rican Cultural Center because if people learn that we have an agency that is serve the community with many programs and many events, we can inform and we can show people that we have a center that is run by a nonprofit organization for the Puerto Rican and in general the community, so they can interact, they can volunteer. We encourage people and acknowledge them to be involved in the Puerto Rican Cultural Center by having the Puerto Rican Parade. People knew and met people there that help them how they do that. So, you know, one of our goals is just to get involved, to know that we're here to help them. We're here to let them know that it's more than just high school, for example. They can dream higher. And the agency is going to run with the help of the people and the help of the volunteers. This is our culture. This is our heritage. We bring that to our community, that is the Hispanic community. We bring people that are not even Hispanic to know our culture, how proud we are, how happy, hey, I'm Puerto Rican and I'm here. So I want you to get involved. I want you to see how our culture is. And by having the Puerto Rican Parade, we have that interact with other people that are not from the same race.
Welcome back to Caribbean Connection. Once again, here's Daddy Yankee with La Bumba. That brings us to the end of another exciting episode of Caribbean Connection. Thanks to all our guests and thank you for watching.
We hope you enjoyed this edition of Caribbean Connection. If you would like to write, here is our address.